We had a couple of good team meetings this past weekend, and it's time for us to pull this team together. This is a big game, and we know what we're up against, but we're ready to get going. And we know this, that we're going to play with a lot of passion and a lot of intensity. We're going to be a team that's disciplined, a team that's focused, and a team that just really enjoy playing. I know the coaches and the players, they're excited about getting back on the practice field so that we can go back to work. And this is the week that we get this playing going, that where we get our confidence back. You know, you look at the previous 2 weeks, we played with so much confidence and played. And it's not so much of how we played, but it's all about, after watching that tape, it's about just doing the little things. And once we do the little things, we know this, that we can be the team that we expect to be. And I know that team last week wasn't a team that we think it should be, but we're going to get better. And that's what it's all about right now.
Coach Strong, obviously you felt close and legitimate arguments as to why you should have won the Cowboy Oklahoma State game. After 50-7 and the way you played against TCU, do you feel like you're far away now? How did that adjust your expectations?
You know what, Sean, it wasn't. I don't think we're far away at all. I just, you know, we didn't have them prepared to play as a coach. And we know this, that we can do better ourselves and be more focused. But that team there at Saturday, I know this. We're a better football team than that, without a doubt. We're a way better football team than that.
Charlie, I'm guessing it. One of those two meetings is when Chris Boyd apologized to his teammates. Will he face any discipline from you?
Chris Boyd, he did apologize to the team, but it's sometimes it's just immaturity. Whenever that happened, don't know when it happened, but yes, and we will handle it within, where we will handle the discipline within. But, you know, it's more of, they know they can't be on their phones. I mean, they can't even, we have a team meeting, they can't be, a phone can't be in the room.
Will he play against OU?
He will play against OU.
Coach, I know you're extremely loyal, but, you know, Dominic Riggs hasn't really been getting anything done this year. Nick Rose has definitely been struggling. Do you have to consider, you know, giving some guys behind them more playing time this week?
Nick Rose, we had a conversation, him and I talked this past weekend. So, and I told him, I said, what we're going to do is open it up for just open competition, and just not very pleased with what we're doing there.
As big of a game as it is this kind of the perfect time for this game? Because you know you'll get everybody locked in because it is such a rivalry and they know what the stakes are against Oklahoma.
You know, Chris, I think back last night, and a lot of times we go out on Sundays, you know, there's a lot of joking and guys are really, you know, just kind of messing around. But last night, you can see that no joking going around, kind of settled in. And I looked at one of our coaches and I said, this game came at the right time for us. So now we can get them focused and get them back. And, you know, when I talk about, hey, it's time for us to get our confidence back and get these guys back on track. And it does. It falls at a great time for us. And so we'll see just, you know, how much that we're going to go out and just go compete and how much we got to get them prepared and get them focused.